Hey guys, Antvenom here, and welcome back to another Minecraft video. And today I'm going to be showing you guys the printer block mod for Minecraft Beta 1.8. If you guys are curious what world I'm in and you ended up missing yesterday's video, this is the world for the laser mod that I actually ended up reviewing yesterday. So if you guys did end up missing it, definitely be sure to check it out because it is an awesome mod. But anyways, moving on to the printer block mod. Essentially what the printer block mod lets you do, I think I'll just call it the printer block. Essentially what the printer block lets you do is it allows you to create very customizable 8-bit art using the wool colors in Minecraft. And before I go getting into its interface and all that, let me show you how to make it here because it really has quite a simple recipe. So if you take a couple of iron ingots just like this, making it in the shape of a minecart, place a wool block in the center, and then appropriately a red, green, and blue dye, you will get a printer. And I can assure you it is not a piece of machinery that hooks up to a redstone computer or something like that. But if you right click on the thing here, you'll notice that you'll get this absolutely giant grid. And then you have a whole bunch of colors on the side and then a whole bunch of other options. So before I get into any of that here, what you kind of need to think of, at least with this arrow, is that this is the direction that you're going to be building. You're going to be building this way, and you're going to be building upwards. So if you right-click on the thing here, and I'll just choose a color just by single-clicking on it, and then clicking on the very bottom right here, and I'll just create a couple blocks just like this, and then I'll hit the print button, because printing is how you you print whatever you have on the screen here in order to show up right here. So yeah, you can kind of see with the way the arrows are set up, that's how that works. And if I left click on this here really quickly, it'll change the orientation in which it's going to end up printing. So if I go up this way here with the white blocks, and you can even see the blue block that was already there still placed, I'll hit print here, and you'll notice that it starts printing out that way. And I'm kind of curious with the mountain here. Let me see what happens if I just like absolutely start spamming up the mountain and then I undo it. So I got a whole bunch of stuff printed in the mountain there. I'm going to clear it and hit print. Okay, so it didn't even leave a hole in the mountain or anything like that. That's kind of awkward, but that's also kind of cool at the same time. So I'm going to left click this here and then clear what I had. And there we go. So the different options within the menus here, like I said, this is just a giant grid, you know, in order to make your 8-bit art. But the options that run along the sign here, you guys have already seen what print and clear does. What replace does is, let's just say you have certain amounts of colors strewn all along the screen or something like that. Yeah, you know, I'm just making random shapes just to give you guys a demonstration. If you hit the replace button here, you'll notice what happens is when I choose a different color in the color palette here, and then I click in any one of the colors that I have on the board, it'll replace all of that color. So if I can hit blue again here, I can replace all of these. So it allows you to change up the color scheme of whatever you are drawing. And let's just say like you're drawing, you know, some bit of 8-bit art and you get the skin color wrong or something. Like, let's just say you used yellow when orange would have been a more fitting color, then you can go ahead and you can make changes just like that. And then I can go ahead and I can hit print here, and it will print out this weird shape that I have done that doesn't really look like much of anything. But anyway, so right clicking again on this here, I'm gonna hit clear, and then I'm gonna hit print, and it's gonna erase everything that I had just done. And moving on, so essentially what the brush size is that you notice that when you're drawing and you can't like click and draw in order to draw, because I'm holding down my left mouse button right now, but if you use the brush size, you can hit the plus button here and you'll have a 3x3 grid of whatever color you have selected, and then you can go up to a 5x5, 7x7, and 9x9, and that is as big as you can go up to with a given brush size. So that's pretty much that. Moving on, with the layers themselves, this is where the whole mod kind of gets really interesting. If you hit the plus button here, you'll notice that it says layer 1 right here, and you have sort of like a ghosted image of everything that is going to be in front of whatever you're drawing. And what I mean by that, like if I place a whole bunch of blocks right here, and I hit print, you're going to notice that it placed these along the layer that is behind the green blocks, because it is layer number 1 instead of layer number 0. And you can do this pretty much infinitely. I think it's like, what is it, up to 99 layers. So let me see if I can actually do this here, see if it'll print all, yeah. You can see it printed 99 layers all the way back there. So you can make some really big structures with this thing. Now, I'm not exactly sure how big this entire thing is. If I had to guess, I would say it's like 50 by 50 or 75 by 75 or something. But needless to say, if you're making 8-bit art with it, then it's going to be more than sufficient for what you're going to end up needing. So why don't I go to layer 99 here? I'll hit clear, and then I'll come all the way back here. I'll go to layer 0, hit clear on that, and I will print it, and it'll delete all the stuff that's back there, and it'll delete that big green blob that I had before. So moving on here. So what these options on the right side here do, they kind of do exactly what you would expect them to do. Drawing a giant thing here, let's just draw something really random. I'll hit copy. What the copy feature does is it literally copies what you have on the board and including the transparent spaces as well. So if I hit paste here, it will delete all the new stuff that I've drawn since copying. And yeah, that's pretty much what the copy and paste features do. Really quite simple. And the undo and redo features are exactly what you would expect. It allows you to undo and redo various things that you've done. So if you place the wrong block, you don't need to go all the way back to this one, the transparent block, in order to erase it. You can just hit the undo button or the redo button, whatever feels fit. So the rectangle button is, like I said, once again, exactly what you would expect. You hit the rectangle button and then you click on one corner and then you drag and you can create rectangles. And yeah, I don't think I need to get into that one any more than that. And the fill feature, once again, is pretty self-explanatory. It doesn't work quite like the replace button does. When you hit fill, it'll just fill the one area of pixels that you have selected. So let's just say, alright, there we go. Let's just see here. Draw. Let's create a couple blocks just like this. There we go. They're nice and separated. And then I hit fill again, and I'll choose brown for a color. This little bit of pixels will be the only one that'll get filled in with the color because it's not actually connected to this with the same color. So anyways, yeah, wow, I think I've pretty much covered everything that I wanted to cover in this particular mod review. But it wouldn't be a fun mod review unless I did a little bit of 8-bit art of my own. Now, I'm not going to be doing anything too much, but, you know, I thought I would do something. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut the footage here to my little piece of 8-bit art that I'm going to make. It's not going to be anything too special, but you know what? It's something to be proud of nonetheless. And there we go, hoping I didn't miss anything. Let's hit the print button here. There we go. And just like that, we have created a giant 8-bit link in a matter of seconds, at least a lot quicker than I could have, rather than manually stacking all sorts of wool all over the place and guessing the colors and not being able to see what I'm making until I stand way far away from it. So that is that in a nutshell. But anyways, guys, I hope you guys have enjoyed this particular mod review, and I highly recommend you check it out for yourself, because I might as well mention this now. A big thing that I like about various mods, you can't really do this with a laser mod, or it doesn't really apply to the laser mod, but I like mods that when they're not installed, their effect will still remain, and it very much happens in this case, because the recipe is so simple for the printer block, and the only thing you really need is the mod in order to make the printer block itself, but the result that comes out of the printer block, it does not need a mod. So that's what I think makes this particular mod and so many other mods so special. So with the sun rising in the background, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to end off the video, guys. But anyways, guys, hope you guys have enjoyed this particular video. My name is Ant Venom, and I bid you all farewell. Thanks so much for watching.